So, Jimmy, can you fill us in on where you're at with the truck that you're working on right now? And just fill us in on what's going on.
I am in the process of spending a tremendous amount of money on my truck. Yes, I could buy a new one right now with the money that I have, but I'm going to keep building on this one. It's going to be perfect. It's going to be terrific. We're going to do it.
Why not just take the money that you spent on everything and just get Super Duty axles and just put it under there and spend even more money on wheels and tires and stuff? That seems more feasible, yeah?
Look, you're still going to be spending a lot of money anyways. What's the point? It's a half-ton truck. We don't need to make it to haul a horse trailer.
What about, you said you're thinking about a limited slip differential. Why not an air locker?
No comment.
Folks, welcome back to Bullford 82. Today, we're working on Betty. I am continuing part of a re-gearing project that I did last year and procrastinated on after I got the rear axle done. After this year's winter, it's pushed me to do the front axle and get that done because I'm tired of having mismatched gears. I just need to get this done. So let me explain to you what I've got going on here. There are some upgrades here while we're changing the gears. This is mainly what I'm changing is just the gears. But when you change gears, sometimes you have to change the carrier out. So let me explain what I got for parts here. So the rear differential, I put 410s in. So we're putting 409 in the front. That'll kind of overdrive it just a smidge. That'll overdrive it just a teeny bit, but we'll still be able to use it perfectly fine on road. On ice, snow, whatever, have normal working four-wheel drive. And then while I was doing the carrier, I was thinking about just doing an open differential, but I'm like, ah, screw it. So I got a Spicer track lock. This is an OEM, brand new, it's not used. Yeah, this is a brand new unit. I got bearings. Let's see, that's the nut. I should have shims around here somewhere. And then I went ahead and bought chromoly axle shafts for the front as well. The axle shafts that are in it now are fine and the U-joints are good, but I've decided to beef it up a little bit. This is a 30% upgrade over stock. So I went ahead and purchased these, and then so we'll have a limited slip, we'll have a stronger axle shafts, and that'll beef up that front end just a little bit more, especially because we're running 35 inch tires. So having a little extra strength in the axles will be good to go. So I need to find out where my shims went. I'm pretty sure I had shims that came with that kit. Let me go look around, but if not, we're going to have to use the factory ones, and that's all I have. That's okay, now I'm annoyed. Oh, yeah, I definitely just got out of bed. I didn't even bother taking a shower. I'm just like, screw it. Today I was actually supposed to go to somewheres with a friend, doing like a cattle run or something. I don't know. That didn't happen today. So I'm home working on my truck. Now, in a video, I haven't even edited it yet, but there's a video working on that blue Ford out there. It was nice. Like, it was a good day. It was dry for the most part. Actually, all day it was dry. I'm feeling pretty good, and I want to work on my truck, even though I am missing shims and the shim kit. We're going to pull the bearings off the old parts and use those shims to see if we can get our setup correct. Because that's what I was going to do anyways. That's what I do with the rear axle. But anyways, I'm going to work on this thing and see what I need along the way. But today's it's the day I'm in a good mood to work on my truck, and look, it's raining. Anyways, enough blabbing. Let's get to tearing this thing apart. Because I'm sure somebody right now is thinking, you know, I just wish she would just shut up. I came here to do an axle rebuild, blah, blah. This is like, you know, kind of just watching a guy in a shop kind of thing. This channel's not a how-to. You might learn something, but it's not a bolt for bolt, nut for nut kind of thing. So, an observant viewer, videos back, had said something about my brakes not engaging all the way. I can assure you they are. Probably what you saw was just surface rust from not driving it, because I think when I did that video I wasn't driving the truck. So there's just surface rust on it, but yeah, they're working pretty good. I almost got to see a car crash. This Honda come flying down the hill like they own the place. And they pulled right out in front of this Ford Ranger that was southbound on the highway. And they locked them up too. It's like, hey, you know, there's traffic and people driving through here. You gotta kind of look. Close your eyes, tubes. Shove that back in there. Yeah, and today I'm gonna take 15 minutes out of a 30 minute video to talk about our newest sponsor. Just kidding. Not a sponsor. I don't do those. Yeah, let's just. Oh, yeah. Even though this one's just a part, just spray that. Spray that, yeah. Just get her nice and wet. 26. Thank you. You like my hammer? Oh yeah. Oh, look at that. Yeah, this new steering box has been really nice. Oh, got a leak somewhere. Redhead. Take back what I said. Yeah, I see that boot's all messed up. I don't think I've ever changed the gear oil on this ever since I put this axle in. I think I just, because it wasn't, the gears in here are original to 1978. So, it wasn't too bad, if I remember correctly, when we took it apart. Those videos are buried deep in my Johnson's Garage channel. Installing the axle, different story. I did it at a friend's barn and, well, you know, things happen. I pulled the videos. Didn't want no problems. It needed an oil change, but not too bad. I did crudely take this thing apart at one point and then slammed it back together, so kind of had some shims that were a little goofy. So that out all the way. Okay, axle shafts are out. Bolts can go wherever, but do not mix up the orientation of your guys here before assembly. Actually, I'm gonna put these in here. So as to not have this fall out on us. Why, that's not budging. Okay, Gerald, slow down now. Yeah, there. Yes! Yes!
Now, are we putting new seals in this? Nope. If you're working on your truck, you can replace your seals if you want.
Cool. We got that out.
Shane is a slide hammer. Okay.
Well, nothing too fancy. Bearings look tight. I didn't really have any noise or anything from this axle. Other than my front drive shaft is overextended, and I think this coating on the splines is either was never there from factory or is worn out. So it sounds like it's full of marbles, and it's quite annoying to listen to. But yeah, so we got our old axle shafts. We match up. The nice thing about these, they give you two spots for C-clips. This one only had one, and this axle shaft, these two, they're original to the Dana 44 that's in the truck now. And this axle was originally like a, from the factory, it was a all-wheel drive or part-time four-wheel drive, but it was always engaged. It just had a drive slug that went in here, and then it just used the one C-clip. This axle shaft, they gave you two spots. So that is where you can run your drive slug, and then this is for a lockout. So I'm missing my C-clips for those. I'm gonna have to order some. Then we can get those on there. I might see if Napa can get me those snap rings. I might even take this stub shaft in there and see if, oh, I bet they can get me one. They have stuff like that there. I might do that tomorrow when I do a parts run. So anyways, yeah, I need to get C-clips for that. But then looking at the new axle shafts, you see right here, it's necked down a little bit. Well, not so much on the new shafts. Yeah, pardon my sniffles. It's cold and I gotta blow my nose. We have extra splines here. And it's not necked down anymore. There's a little bit of a groove there on that axle. No groove there because that's brand new. I got new Spicer U-joints, stronger U-joints supposedly. The U-joints I have in here are just Napa brand. They've been fine. I'm not necessarily hard with this thing off-road. I'm not doing a whole lot of rock crawling or anything, so I end up not really breaking those. So I'm kind of thankful for that. But yeah, these are our new gears. We got 409s, and then we have a limited slip carrier. That gear we could actually set on there and get our new bolts. I got new bolts here. We could put those on, Loctite them, snug them, and then when we get them into the axle, we'll torque it, do a final torque on it. I actually need to take my rear axle and change the fluid again on it, since it is still kind of rebuilt or still breaking in. We need to check the fluid on that, and I want to check the bolts. I don't think I torqued the bolts, and that's kind of got me worried just a little bit. But yeah, we're gonna have a limited slip differential now. That'll be really nice. This is a Spicer track lock. My goal was to use as much factory stuff as I could for the gears and the differential and the bearings, U-joints. These axle shafts are made by Yukon Gear and Axle, and it's the same company that makes the axle shafts I put in the rear axle. And those are the heavy duty. I believe they were chrome moly as well. So this truck will actually have a lot stronger axles in it, you know, for half ton purpose. These seals, I'm really happy that these are good. We'll just clean those up. They're obviously pressed up against it, the spindle without the C-clip. So that means that water and stuff's not getting in and killing the spindle bearing or the stub shaft bearing. It does come with new slingers. We're gonna put those on and then transfer our, we'll clean up the rubbers and we'll transfer them over to the new shafts. But yeah, definitely a little bit more meat on them. That's for sure. So that's cool. We'll catch you in the next video. The next video will be kind of getting the new parts set up, which will be involving pulling this bearing off, taking the shims out, measuring them so that we know what size they are, writing it down. We'll put it on the new bit there, and then we'll put our new bearings on. And then, and same thing with the pinion. We'll transfer the shim from that pinion to that one, and then we'll put it in, we'll snug her down, and we'll see what our gear pattern looks like. If our gear pattern looks anything like this, I'm gonna pretty much just send that home. So yeah, as you can tell, I gotta blow my nose.
I gotta go. See you guys later. Take it easy. Check out the links down below and subscribe if you haven't already. We'll see you later.